Hi friends, welcome to Curious Vet channel once again. I am Dr. Mohsina. In today's video, we will learn about a toxic plant which is very important as far as veterinary toxicology is concerned. Today, we will discuss about lupine toxicity in animals. So, this is a picture of blue lupine. There are different varieties of lupine. Lupines or lupinous species cause two distinct forms of poisoning in livestock. One is lupine poisoning and the other one is lupinosis. We will see one by one. First is lupine poisoning. It is a nervous syndrome caused by alkaloids present in bitter lupines. And lupinosis is a mycotoxic disease characterized by liver injury and jaundice, which results mainly from the feeding of sweet lupines. So lupine poisoning is caused by bitter lupines, whereas lupinosis is caused by mycotoxins present in sweet lupines. Lupinosis is important in Australia and South Africa and also has been reported from New Zealand and Europe. Sheep and occasionally cattle and horses are affected, and pigs are also susceptible. So first, let's see lupine poisoning. It is caused by some alkaloids present in bitter lupines. Different quinolycidine alkaloids in various species of lupine can cause either neurologic signs or teratogenesis. Sheep are often more affected with neurologic signs by acute toxicity to lupine. But horses and cattle are also sometimes affected. Cattle experience fetal teratogenesis more often than sheep. Classic lesions are arthrogryposis or crooked calf or cleft palate. So this is a picture of arthrogryposis in calf or crooked calf. You can see the flexed joints. And here comes the picture of cleft palate in calf. So this teratogenesis are caused by lupine poisoning in cattle. But sheep are more commonly found to be showing neurologic signs. Some laboratories can assay for lupine alkaloids in urine or serum. So these can be collected to help confirm the diagnosis in sheep. Other plants with similar nicotinic acting alkaloids include tobacco, Indian tobacco, lorikeet, Scottish broom, mountain thermopsis and poison hemlock. The best course of action is to move the animals to safer pastures. So that's all about lupine poisoning. Now let's see lupinosis. The causal fungus is Phormopsis leptostomiformis, which causes Phormopsis stem blight, especially in white and yellow lupines, and blue varieties of lupines are resistant to this fungus. So these are the pictures of white and yellow lupines. So the fungus is affecting white and yellow lupines, and blue varieties are resistant to this fungus. Coming to the clinical findings, clinical changes are mainly attributable to toxic hepatocyte injury, which causes mitotic arrest in metaphase, isolated cell necrosis, and hepatic enzyme leakage with loss of metabolic and excretory function. Early signs in sheep and cattle are inappetence and listlessness. Complete anorexia and jaundice follow, and ketosis is common. Cattle may show lacrimation and salivation. Ketosis is a common sequel in pregnant cattle or recently calved cows. Survivors may develop hepatic cirrhosis. Sheep may become photosensitive and a skeletal muscle myopathy can develop. As disease progresses, liver failure may cause hepatoencephalopathy characterized by stumbling, disorientation, and recumbency before death. Lesions. In acute disease, icterus is marked. Livers are enlarged, orange, yellow, and fatty. So this is the picture showing enlarged orange yellow liver caused by lupinosis. More chronic cases show bronze or tan colored livers that are firm, contracted in size, and fibrotic. Copious amounts of transudates may be found in abdominal and thoracic cavities and in the pericardial sac. Some animals may have spongiform lesions in the brain. Coming to diagnosis, feeding of moldy lupine material together with clinical signs and increased levels of serum liver enzymes strongly indicate lupinosis. Control. Frequent surveillance of sheep and of lupine fodder material for characteristic black spot fungal infestation, especially after rains, is advised. The utilization of lupine cultivars bred and developed for resistance to the fungus Phormopsis leptostomiformis is advocated, and oral doses of zinc have protected sheep against hepatic injury caused by lupinosis. So that's all about lupine toxicity in animals. If you find the video helpful, please like it and share it with your friends and comment your suggestions. If you are new to this channel and not subscribed yet, please subscribe and click the notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a video. I will be uploading at least one video every week. So see you soon with another video. Thank you.